Welcome to the Philippines' premier motor show. This is Autofocus. I'm Ray Louis Gamboa. Here are our features on this edition of your electronic magazine, exclusive to the automobile and its industry.
Starting off with reviews of two vehicle models presently in the local market. A compact SUV from Suzuki, the Vitara All-Grip, and a subcompact crossover from Subaru, the XV 2.0 IS iSight. Plus a feature-to-feature comparison of two 4x4 pickup trucks, the Ford Ranger FX4 Mach versus the Nissan Navara Pro 4X. On Autopedia, we'll talk about how a supercharger works, and together with the latest news and developments in the local auto industry, we shall have the launch of the Volkswagen Combi as our special feature.
The next 60 minutes is all about the automobile. This is Autofocus, and we'll be right back after this short break.
I think my dad is secretly a superhero. He's the coolest, smartest, strongest person alive. No matter where we go, he always makes sure I feel safe. And he isn't afraid of anything. My dad likes to call that the power to lead. I call it his superpower.
Be part of the 2021-2022 Autofocus People's Choice Awards, the only nationwide poll to determine the country's most popular car brands and models. It's easy. Log on to bit.ly/AFPCA2021, then vote for as many as 5 different models that you believe should become the 2021-2022 Autofocus Automobile of the Year in separate, standard, and premium luxury categories. Vote every day until November 30, 2021. The Autofocus People's Choice Awards. Who will win? You choose, you decide. Vote now.
The Mitsubishi Strata Athlete, confident to the core.
Welcome back to Autofocus, the automobile show. We start this edition of your electronic magazine with a review of one of the latest automobile models from Suzuki. Suzuki has upped the ante in the compact SUV segment with a 4x4 offering. CarView takes a look at the new Suzuki Vitara All-Grip.
Suzuki Philippines is looking to carve a good slice of the compact SUV market with the introduction of the new Vitara All-Grip. The new Suzuki Vitara is 4,175mm long, 1,775mm wide, and 1,610mm at its highest point, with a 2,500mm wheelbase and a minimum ground clearance of 185mm. Suzuki maintained the clambake bonnet design of the Vitara but modernized with softer curves while sticking to a design scheme based on trapezoids for the fascia and the rear. Exterior upgrades include LED headlamps for low beam, unique DRLs, vertical chrome grille, front and rear skid plates, a front lower bumper garnish, chrome and black grain accents on the side, black rear spoiler, silver roof rails, wheel arc extensions, and 17-inch polished alloy wheels. Standard exterior features include headlamp leveling device, front fog lamps, power adjustable and folding side view mirrors with integrated turn signals, and electromagnetic tailgate opener. The Vitara All-Grip comes with keyless entry and push start button. The cabin offers comfortable seating for 5 on leather and suede type fabric upholstered seats with stitching. Good driving position is easily attained with height adjustable driver seat and tilt and telescoping steering wheel. Wrapped in leather, the steering wheel also comes with controls for audio, cruise control, and speed limiter. the rear seat back fold 6040 to provide more space for luggage and other cargo. Suzuki went all in with sporty circular dials for the dash and instrumentation. Sitting on top, front and center are twin round air vents with circular clock in the middle. A 4.2-inch LCD multi-info display sits in between large dials for the speedometer and tachometer. Underneath the air vents and clock sits the 10-inch display for the infotainment system, which comes with smartphone linkage, navigation system, and even clinometer to show pitch and roll angles of the Vitara, a compass as well as barometer readings. It also comes with front and rear speakers as well as tweeters. Look up and you can see the sky through the panoramic sunroof consisting of two glass panels that slide open. Other standard comfort and convenience features include center armrest, central door locks, automatic air conditioning, 12-volt accessory socket, USB port, rear camera and parking sensors. The Suzuki Vitara All-Grip is powered by a 1,586cc 4-cylinder gasoline engine that generates 115 horsepower and 156 Nm of torque. It comes with a 6-speed automatic transmission and the 4-wheel drive All-Grip Select drivetrain, which Suzuki says makes the Vitara fun to drive, provide high fuel efficiency while giving driver peace of mind taking on tough roads and weather conditions. The 4-wheel drive All-Grip Select drivetrain allows the driver to choose 4 drive modes, Auto, Sport, Snow, and Lock, using the round dial behind the shift knob. Auto mode prioritizes fuel economy by mainly using 2-wheel drive while automatically switching to 4-wheel drive if wheel spin is detected. Sport mode is optimized for driving aggressively on winding roads by actively using 4-wheel drive and allocating torque on wheels to improve cornering performance while keeping revs high for good response. Snow mode is optimal for unpaved and other slippery features, using mainly 4-wheel drive to assist in stability and enhancing traction during acceleration on slippery roads. Lock is used to help extricate the vehicle from mud or sand by applying brakes to slipping wheels and torque to gripping wheels. Suzuki also equipped the new Vitara with driver assist tech and standard safety feature buyers now expect in SUVs, such as anti-lock braking system with electronic brake force distribution, electronic stability program, hill hold control, hill descent control, brake assist function. Also included for safety and security are dual, front, side, and curtain airbag, 3-point ELR seat belts for 5, ISOFIX and child seat teeth or anchorage, child-proof rear door locks, side impact door beams, pedal release system, and immobilizer. The new Vitara All-Grip comes in galactic gray metallic and cool white pearl colors. Two-tone color variants include prime solar yellow with cosmic black pearl metallic and solid bright red with cosmic black pearl metallic. The monotone variant is priced at 1.458 million pesos, while the two-tone variant is priced at 1.468 million pesos.
If you're looking for a compact SUV with all-wheel drive capability, the Suzuki Vitara All-Grip should be worth a careful once-over and test drive. The latest auto industry news and developments right after this break.
Suzuki Eltiga.
Life is beating fast. Find what you're waiting for.
Seven-seater in style.
I think my dad is secretly a superhero. He's the coolest, smartest, strongest person alive. No matter where we go, he always makes sure I feel safe. And he isn't afraid of anything. My dad likes to call that the power to lead. I call it his superpower.
Humans choose more challenging paths to go up and over our biggest obstacle. Ourselves. New Ford Ranger FX4 Max. Live the Ranger life.
Welcome back to AutoFocus. We now have the latest auto industry news.
Ford Philippines has brought in the new Mustang Shelby GT500. This Mustang has got a 5.2-liter supercharged cross-plane crank V8 engine, packing 760 horses and 847 Nm of maximum torque, mated with a 7-speed Tremec dual-clutch transmission. It comes with performance-enhancing features like, among many other things, MagnaRide damping system, 3.73 torsion limited-slip rear differential, Brembo brake calipers, magnesium tower-to-tower brakes, and electronic line lock and launch control. There's all manner bells and whistles fit for top-end performance cars, including track apps and 12-inch LCD digital instrument cluster with MyColor, 8-inch capacitive center touchscreen with swipe capability, 2 smart charging multimedia ports, and Apple CarPlay and Android Auto compatibility. You can have one for just 7,760,000 pesos. Add 15,000 pesos for one in Twister Orange. Ford is also teasing pickup enthusiasts about the next generation Ranger that is coming soon. The big reveal for what Ford says is the smartest, most capable, and most versatile Ranger yet will be happening before the year is over. September will be memorable for those who take up Toyota Motor Philippines' incredible deals for the new vehicle purchases, free maintenance services, and other exclusives. One can drive home a Wego e-manual for as low as 5,970 pesos a month, an Innova 2.8J diesel manual for 12,372 pesos. Toyota is also offering an all-in package rate of 192,750 pesos for the Innova 2.8E diesel manual. The Fortuner G4x2 automatic can be had for 16,992 pesos a month, and the Hi-Ace Commuter Deluxe for 17,155 pesos. Toyota is also offering free period maintenance of up to 20,000 kilometers for select variants of the Vios, Corolla Altis, Rush, Innova, Fortuner, Hilux, and Hi-Ace. Also, all Toyota customers are entitled to a free safety inspection at all Toyota dealerships nationwide from September 1 to 30, 2021. Hyundai Asia Resources has launched the Hyundai Move, or Mobility Virtual Experience. Hyundai Move is designed to further engage Hyundai vehicle owners online via a virtual city that is divided into 6 zones, each promising a one-of-a-kind experience. These include the Me and My Hyundai Ride Photo Contest, where participants submit imaginative photos of themselves with their Hyundai vehicles. The Most Memorable Ride Story Contest, where participants share a 20-word account of their best experience with their Hyundai vehicle, dealership, or Hari-sponsored activity. The Test Your High Story Quiz, where participants answer 20 trivia questions about Hyundai in the Philippines. The Wishboard, a venue for posting comments, greetings, and well wishes to other Hyundai owners. The Best Ride Ever, where participants vote on the best Hyundai vehicle ever. And the Drive Forward Theater, a virtual movie house where participants can watch videos produced by Hari and Hyundai Motor Company. It's September, and already Mitsubishi Motor Philippines has a Yuletide treat for buyers. Mitsubishi Motor Philippines calls it the September Blowout Promo. The promo involves low down payment deals for the Mitsubishi Mirage, Expander, Strada, Montero Sport, and L300 until the end of the month. It's 28,000 pesos all-in for the Mirage, 78,000 pesos for the Expander Cross, 88,000 pesos for the Strada, 168,000 pesos for the Montero Sport, and 88,000 pesos for the L300.
Those are the latest news and developments in the automotive industry. We shall take another short break. Stay with us. I'll be right back.
I think my dad is secretly a superhero. He's the coolest, smartest, strongest person alive. No matter where we go, he always makes sure I feel safe. And he isn't afraid of anything. My dad likes to call that the power to lead. I call it his superpower.
Be part of the 2021-2022 AutoFocus People's Choice Awards, the only nationwide poll to determine the country's most popular car brands and models. It's easy. Log on to bit.ly/AFPCA2021, then vote for as many as 5 different models that you believe should become the 2021-2022 AutoFocus Automobile of the Year in separate, standard, and premium luxury categories. Vote every day until November 30, 2021. The Auto Focus People's Choice Awards. Who will win? You choose, you decide. Vote now.
extra
with the Mitsubishi Xpander Cross.
Every time I'm on the road, I can expect high performance from Phoenix Fuels. Now with Pulse technology, delivers enhanced power and acceleration to make every trip come alive.
Welcome back to Autofocus, the country's premier automobile news and features electronic magazine. Here's our feature-to-feature comparison of the latest automobile models belonging to the same category on Head-to-Head. Pickup buyers are now spoiled for choice with many brands and models available, and with each brand or model offering multiple variants. This head-to-head pits the Ford Ranger FX4 Max against the Nissan Navara Pro 4X in a spec-to-spec comparison.
Pickup trucks and 4x4 drivetrains are now sold as lifestyle vehicles and not only as utility vehicles with on- and off-road capabilities. Two recent examples are the Ford Ranger FX4 Max and the Nissan Navara Pro 4X. The Ford Ranger FX4 Max is 5,354mm long, 1,860mm wide, and 1,852mm tall. Exterior highlights include grille with large Ford mark, matte black full-length sports bar, metal hoop non-slip slide steps. It also comes with projector-type headlamps, halogen front fog lamps, rain-sensing wipers, side mirrors with turn signals that adjust and fold electronically, bed liner and 17-inch alloy wheels wrapped by 265/70R17 BF Goodrich all-terrain tires. The Nissan Navara Pro 4X 4x4 is 5,260mm long, 1,875mm wide, and 1,855mm tall. Exterior highlights dark-colored front grille with a black and orange Nissan logo, the body-colored front bumper with orange accents, the black tailgate assist, black window molding, and gloss black roof rails. It also comes with quad LED projector headlamps, LED daylight running lights, fog lamps and taillights, the rain wipers, sidestep high mount stop lamp, front and rear mud guards, as well as the utility track channel, and 17-inch gloss black alloy wheels wrapped by all-terrain 255/65R17 tires. The FX4 Max comes with smart keyless entry with push start button. Interior highlights include leather seat upholstery, carbon accents with Miko suede inserts, FX4 embroidery, leather wrapped steering wheel with black alley inserts, all-weather front and rear floor mats. The driver's seat manually adjusts 6 ways, the front passenger seat adjusts 4 ways. The rear bench seat features a fold-down center armrest. Other interior features are power windows, dual-zone automatic air conditioning, dual-color 4.2-inch cluster screens, and the auxiliary switch pack. The FX4 Max infotainment system features 8-inch color touchscreen, Apple CarPlay and Android Auto capability, sync through with voice-activated controls, Bluetooth and phone audio streaming, 2 USB ports, and 6 speakers. The Navara Pro 4X 4x4 comes with keyless entry system with Nissan's intelligent key function, push-button engine start-stop system. Interior highlights include zero-gravity type seats wrapped in leather with Pro 4X stitching. The front seats manually slide, decline, and adjust for height. Other interior features include center console with armrest, a center upper tray, meter cluster with a 7-inch color TFT display, power windows and door locks, dual climate control system with rear vents, a 12-volt socket, and USB port for device and gadgets. The Navara Pro 4X infotainment system uses the Nissan 8-inch advanced touchscreen display audio unit that comes with Apple CarPlay and Android Auto, Bluetooth or hands-free calling, audio streaming, radio tuner, and 6 speakers. Underneath the hood of the FX4 Max is a 2-liter bi-turbo diesel engine capable of generating 213 PS and 500 Nm of torque. This is attached to a 10-speed automatic transmission and 4x4 drivetrain. The suspension features new 2-inch monotube Fox shock absorbers on all four wheels, with coil springs in front and modified leaf springs in the rear. The Navara Pro 4X is powered by a 2,488cc diesel engine with variable turbocharger and intercooler capable of generating 190 PS and 450 Nm of torque. The engine is mated to a 7-speed automatic transmission with manual mode and a part-time 4-wheel drive system with shift-on-the-fly capability for shifting from 2H, 4H, and 4L mode. The Navara Pro 4X comes with an independent double wishbones with coil spring and stabilizer bar in front and 5-link system with dual rate coil spring and stabilizer bar in the rear. The brakes use ventilated disc in front and drums in the rear. The Ford Ranger FX4 Max comes in standard, airbags for driver and front seat passenger and seat belts and child seat ISOFIX anchorage points. It is also equipped with hill launch assist and hill descent, anti-lock brake system plus electronic brake force distribution, electronic stability control with rollover mitigation and traction control as well as rear parking sensors. The Navara Pro 4X 4x4 comes with Nissan Intelligent Mobility, a suite of driver assist tech systems that include intelligent emergency braking, driver attention alert, blind spot warning, rear cross traffic alert, lane departure warning, high beam assist, hill start assist, and hill descent control, as well as the around view monitor and off-road monitor. Also added for safety are SRS airbags, 3-point ELR seat belts for 5, anti-lock brake system with electronic brake force distribution and brake assist, speed sensing door locks and ISOFIX and tether anchors, vehicle dynamic control with trailer stability assist and 4-wheel active brake limited slip. The Navara also comes in anti-theft system with alarm and engine immobilizer.
The pickup segment needs a lot more comparos as the number of models and variants with multiple trim levels continues to increase.
Isuzu D-Max into new heights.
Be it fine dining, a romantic garden wedding, a relaxed casual meal, or an important business event, Ilustrado is the place to go. Aside from its famed paella, the Ilustrado restaurant, which is located within the history-laden walled city of Intramuros, is also the favorite destination of food gourmands for its famous callos and lengua and other classic gustatory offerings. Ilustrado Restaurant, only for the foodies.
Be part of the 2021-2022 Autofocus People's Choice Awards, the only nationwide poll to determine the country's most popular car brands and models. It's easy. Log on to bit.ly/AFPCA2021, then vote for as many as 5 different models that you believe should become the 2021-2022 Autofocus Automobile of the Year in separate, standard, and premium luxury categories. Vote every day until November 30, 2021. The Autofocus People's Choice Awards. Who will win? You choose, you decide. Vote now.
Motul is the most trusted motor oil of the top teams competing in some of the world's most grueling race competitions, the WRC, the WTCC, and the Japan GT. Motul is the only 100% fully synthetic motor oil in the market. It has antioxidation properties that prevent premature thickening and aging due to thermal stress and guarantees total engine protection. For more information about Motul engine oils, visit www.motul.com.ph.
Welcome back to Autofocus, the country's premier automobile news and features electronic magazine. Our special feature is next. Volkswagen Philippines has reached far back into the 60s and 70s, the flower power years in bring back an iconic van to Philippine shores, the Combi. But the multivan is no longer the affordable hippie combi van of yore. Instead, It's a premium van aimed at captains, or at very least, lieutenants of industries. The following special feature seeks why Volkswagen Philippines took this route and where it is taking the brand.
Around the middle of this year, Volkswagen Philippines formally announced that it would be bringing back the Combi to local shores. In confirming the upcoming arrival of the Combi, Volkswagen harked back to the past when the van, with its iconic design, utility, and affordability, was extremely popular locally and globally.
I think a lot of the allure of the Combi was because it was, you know, quite popular for families and even just, you know, for different groups of customers. There were a lot of them on the streets, and in some cases, they actually happened to be part of some notable historical events, right? So you can look back to the periods of like Woodstock in the United States. During that particular social, cultural, and political time in the history of the U.S., the Combi was part of the pictures and the images that you will see of that event.
When Volkswagen finally announced the arrival of the first batch of Combi vans, many noticed that they were far from the practical, utilitarian, and easily affordable vans of old, but the top-of-the-line variant of a very premium luxury van, laden with modern features and the latest in automotive technologies, powered by a 2.0-liter TDI diesel engine, mated to a 7-speed direct-shift gearbox with Tiptronic function. Equipped with powered, dual sliding doors and tailgate, with seats, captain chairs no less, upholstered in Napa leather to match door trims and other premium interior accents. A cabin that transforms into a boardroom. Loaded with driver assist technologies for greater safety and convenience, in the latest tech for smart connectivity, like Discover Media, indispensable tools for successful executives. All this coming with an introductory retail price of around 3.5 million pesos. What was the reason behind this choice?
The particular Combi that we have in the country is the top of the line variant. It comes with the features commensurate, I guess, with that product positioning. There are other variants in the multivan line or in the Volkswagen van line that have different product propositions. Some of the names may be familiar to some of the automotive buyers here in the country, like the Transporter, the Caravelle, or the California. But it's important to note that these are all different products, right? The Transporter, for example, is a utility vehicle. But if that were brought into the country, it would be a very premium utility vehicle, which might be a contradiction in terms. And the Caravelle also would probably sit somewhere in between that and the current Combi that we have. And so we thought that the Combi would actually, the multivan Combi that we have on offer now is actually the most appropriate one for the segment that we're targeting.
In bringing back the Combi to local shores, Volkswagen said the multivan isn't just a van. It has become a conveyance of success and prestige, and that its luxurious yet understated design perfectly reflects owners at the peak of his or her career. But despite moving upmarket, the multivan still harks back to the past with units that have two-tone paint livery that distinguish the Combi of old.
Of course, the old Combis, this was one of the unique things. The two-tone color configuration was available in the old Combi, and that's why we wanted to make sure that we could make that available to customers now, to parang at least bring back the memory and connect the emotions with the past.
So how is Volkswagen planning to make the Combi multivan a player in the premium van segment? What advantage does it have over the competition?
Not only is it the combination of features and qualities of the car, but we've priced it also to be very competitive vis-a-vis within its segment, within the premium executive and family van segment. So if you benchmark us against some of the products out there, I think you immediately know that the offer price we have for the Combi is probably the lowest compared to what's out there. And so all these features, all these qualities, plus the option to take in a two-tone color and really personalize your car at the price that it's being offered at. I mean, I think and I hope that that a lot of people will see that.
The VW Combi Multivan arrived just ahead of health authorities, placing Metro Manila and many parts of the country back under stricter ECQ restrictions. But before this happened, what was the market's reception to a new arrival in the premium executive van segment? And will the restrictions affect VW Philippines' plans to bring in more combis, as well as other VW models and variants?
We were very thoughtful about the number of units we first brought in as our initial offer into the market. We're very happy that we were able to make some deliveries before ECQ hit. So there are actually some combis out there. Not a lot, of course, but given that it's a niche product. But there are already customers who are enjoying the combi. Unfortunately, not only do we have to deal with ECQ, we have to deal with the global realities of the pandemic as well, plus logistical challenges brought about by the pandemic. So this obviously translates to a little bit more lead time in terms of our ability to source. So you're right, our second batch is probably coming in the latter part of this year. We think we have enough in the first batch anyway to service what we expect will be the purchases of customers between now and the time our next batch comes.
Meanwhile, Volkswagen Philippines extends an invitation to VW enthusiasts and would-be buyers to visit in its showrooms.
Again, I'd like to invite our existing Volkswagen followers, fans, and our prospective customers to please check out the Combi and, you know, allow yourself to be immersed in the memories and the attachments, perhaps perhaps those of your parents and maybe even grandparents, of the pictures of the good old days that maybe you had the chance to see with the Combi. The Combi is available in our dealerships to visit and to see. So we invite everyone.
Volkswagen Philippines is looking to replicate the success of the old iconic Combi as the van for everyone back in the day, with the new Combi Multivan in their premium executive van market of today. The Combi Multivan certainly has the potential to do so.
Part of the 2021-2022 Autofocus People's Choice Awards, the only nationwide poll to determine the country's most popular car brands and models. It's easy. Log on to bit.ly/AFPCA2021, then vote for as many as 5 different models that you believe should become the 2021-2022 Autofocus Automobile of the Year in separate, standard, and premium luxury categories. Vote every day until November 30, 2021. The Autofocus People's Choice Awards. Who will win? You choose, you decide. Vote now.
I think my dad is secretly a superhero. He's the coolest, smartest, strongest person alive. No matter where we go, he always makes sure I feel safe. And he isn't afraid of anything. My dad likes to call that the power to lead. I call it his superpower. Da, da, da.
Make long distance easy with the Mirage G4.
Welcome back. We have more cars for you to know and appreciate as we have our second car review this week. Subaru has brought in the XV with the latest midlife upgrade. This edition of Car Review takes a look at what's new in Subaru's popular subcompact crossover.
Since it first arrived in the country, the Subaru XV has carved itself a good niche in the crossover segment. At 4,485 mm long, 1,800 mm wide, and 1,650 mm tall, with a 220 mm ground clearance, the 2021 Subaru XV still slots right in between your traditional subcompact and compact SUV. The XV's overall look doesn't stray much from the basic hatchback design from which it originally sprung in 2012. Aside from their rather love it or hate it design, Subarus have developed a following for their boxer engines and all-wheel symmetrical drive system. In 2018, Subaru rolled out the latest generation XV, now built on the Subaru Global platform, that it said improved maneuverability and reduced vibration and noise. The latest generation XV also came with advanced driver assist and safety technologies, proprietary and not proprietary, that added to its attraction to its loyal flock in a still growing niche. A niche that now has more and more players. Faced with this, Subaru has brought in the XV with mid-cycle upgrades as the 2021 model. Not much has changed to the exterior of the 2021 Subaru XV 2.0 IS EyeSight beyond subtle changes to the headlights, bumper and grille, and tinted rear combination lights. Also new are LED front fog lamps, the 18-inch aluminum alloy wheels with the love him or hate him razor wire design, and the reverse auto tilt doors mirrors. The 2021 Subaru XV 2.0 IS exterior still features auto-leveling bifunctional LED headlamps that respond to steering input, power folding door mirrors with LED turn signal, rear fog lamp, roof rails, roof spoiler, shark fin antenna, and power sliding tilt-adjustable glass sunroof. Inside, the center of the dashboard still features 6.3-inch LCD screen on top of the 8-inch touchscreen display for the infotainment system with Apple CarPlay and Android Auto. In front of the driver is the instrument cluster with a 4.2-inch display between the round speedometer and tachometer dials. Subaru has added to the treasure trove of comfort and convenience features in the XV. Among the new features in this respect are the 8-way power adjustable driver's seat that now comes with memory functions and the speed-sensing auto door locks. The 2021 Subaru XV still features, among other things, keyless access and push-button start, a multifunction steering wheel that tilts and telescopes, paddle shifters, dual-zone automatic air conditioning system, 60-40 split folding rear seats, rear seat armrest, USB ports. Also retained in the new is the old XV powertrain, the 1,995cc boxer engine that generates 156 PS at 6,000 RPM and 196 Nm of torque at 4,000 RPM, mated to a linear-tronic, continuously variable transmission with 7-speed manual mode. Many consider that a drawback in the XV that should have been addressed. As it is, Subaru claims a 0-100 km/h time of 10.4 seconds for the XV, as well as a top speed of 194 km/h. But a common complaint in the XV that was addressed, as many who test drove the new XV have attested to, was the suspension that didn't ride small bumps and road imperfections well. Subaru said the XV's independent all-wheel suspension featuring front McPherson struts and rear double wishbones has been tweaked to fix that problem. Subaru grew its rep and worldwide renown from its fun-to-drive character early on owing to its boxer engine and symmetrical all-wheel drive system. It later added driving assist, as well as active and passive safety technologies and systems, making Subarus even more fun and safe to drive. New in the 2021 Subaru XV is Dual Function X Mode, an SI Drive or Subaru Intelligent Drive with Sport and Intelligent Mode. Active and preventive safety features in the 2021 Subaru include SuperView Around Recognition 360 System, Subaru Rear Vehicle Detection, Reverse Automatic Braking, Active Park Vectoring, Rear Cross Traffic Alert, Brake Assist and Brake Override, Vehicle Dynamics Control System, Auto Vehicle Hold. Added to this is the Subaru EyeSight Driver Assist technology, which comes with pre-collision braking and throttle management, lane departure and sway warning, and adaptive cruise control and lead vehicle start alert. Passive safety systems include front, side, curtain airbags, knee SRS airbag for driver, 3-point seatbelts for 5, auto-retracting safety pedals, side impact door beams.
The 2021 Subaru XV 2.0 IS certainly has a lot going for it in a very competitive crossover segment. Although many still wish it had a bigger boxer motor under its hood. Know more about your car and how to take care of it here on Autopedia.
Hi, this is Sydney, and today we'll be talking about the supercharger. Superchargers and turbochargers, you hear these two terms thrown around interchangeably, and can't really blame the people on the internet because they don't really know what it is. They have no idea what it looks like, much less know how it works. So we've covered turbochargers in a past topic, so this time we'll be covering the supercharger. So basically, let's start with the similarities. Turbo and supercharger. Both of these things are called forced induction because you are force feeding more air into the engine. It's just that the way that they do it are different. A turbo uses the exhaust gases to spin a turbine that feeds air. A supercharger, on the other hand, uses a belt like this, connected to the engine, connected to the alternator, water pump, aircon compressor, that spins two rotors in here that also force more air in. Same principle, get more air, suck more air, blow more air, make more power. The main difference between the supercharger and turbocharger is of the hardware itself. Almost all turbochargers are two circular round things. Superchargers come in this rectangular package because inside here are two intermeshing lobes. They look like gears. So what they basically do is it's also an air pump. It goes like this, air goes in, gets forced out, creates pressure. Nothing different from a turbocharger in terms of principle of operation, but how it operates is one is belt driven, one is exhaust driven. Now, let's address the popular notion, oh, superchargers have parasitic loss and all of that. No, it's not true. Whatever you read on it, once again, it's not true. Yes, it takes some energy to turn this, but that energy is a lot less than what the energy that it gives. Because if it is parasitic loss, and you're actually using more energy to turn this than what it makes, then there's no point in installing this in the first place. Let's put that in numbers. To turn this thing here, the assembly here with the lobes inside, takes about 5 horsepower from the engine. But what this gives you in return is about 40 horsepower on this 1.5 liter Honda City engine. So power-wise, for a 1.5 engine, we're adding 40 horsepower more. Basically, the behavior is like stuffing a big 2.4 liter engine into a car this small. That's the easiest way to describe the driving style and result of a supercharger. It feels like a big engine. The power curve is actually a straight line from idle all the way to red light. It's one straight line. No dips, no curves, no nothing. And it's very, very linear, which makes it a great choice for racing because unlike turbochargers, which have surge and sometimes depending on what size the turbo is, there's a lag when you let go. It's not very great when you're coming out of a corner. This is more predictable when it comes to driving and racing. So turbocharger, supercharger, which is better? One is not better than the other. One does not make more power than the other. If you're doing this on your project car, say a Civic 1.8, there is a limit to how much horsepower you can make. Go over that limit, whether it's turbo or supercharger, then you'll break the engine. It all depends on really what you want. And of course, how much you're going to pay. Some people may say, oh, I'll spend 200 grand on a supercharger for 40 horses. But if I do turbocharger, it's only 130, 140,000. I'll go with the cheaper option. Well, that's up to you. But the biggest advantage of a supercharger system is most of these things are made in kit form. So everything that you need to be able to install it comes with it. So this one here actually installs in one day. A custom turbo setup where everything will have to be fabricated from scratch will take about a week. That's the fastest, to an average of a week and a half to 2 weeks. So you figure out how much your downtime is worth. So that's the how and why it works of a supercharger.
That's our feature on Autopedia this week. Taking care of your ride has been made easier. And that's Autofocus this week. We hope you have found this edition of your electronic automobile magazine informative as well as entertaining. Check us out on Facebook, Twitter, and Instagram accounts. On behalf of my dad, Butch Gamboa, this has been your host, Ray Louis Gamboa. Please stay safe and healthy.